Hey guys, Toby Mathis here. One of the questions that we get a lot of is how do I build a recession-proof portfolio so I don't have to worry about what's going on in the market? Like I could sleep at night, I can go on vacation, I don't have to be watching the stock market 24/7. Well, if you know Infinity, we buy for the long haul. We buy things with the intent to hold on to it forever. We're not big sellers of items. We tend to be more on the buying side. And then we sell options on that. We rent out our stock so that we can compound some of the income. That said, we do not want to have to worry about the fluctuations in the market. One of the easiest ways to tell whether or not your portfolio is going to be recession-proof is to look in the past and check out what's happened in past recessions. So we might be looking at 2008, 9, 10, 11, 12, that whole area where we just got beat on, where you had a close to 40% pullback in the market, and say, is my portfolio going to be successful if I back test it? So I tend to focus on something called dividend aristocrats and dividend kings, things that have been successful in increasing their dividends, the payouts to the shareholders, for a period of time of 25 to 50 years plus. Because that's a pretty good indication in if it's successful in past recessions, how is it going to be in future recessions? Well, if something got beat up during a past recession, you could probably count on it getting beat up if there's a recession now. So you want to be looking at companies that are going to be, usually it's a lot of utilities, a lot of things that are consumables, a lot of things that are not going to just disappear. Luxury items tend to go out the wayside when you're in a recession. So things that are not susceptible to those types of challenges. And that's why we tend to, again, look at our aristocrats and kings, the three M's of the world, Procter & Gamble, Johnson & Johnson, Walgreens, Walmarts of the world, all those things. We're looking at them because no matter what, they're probably going to be okay. Now, there's no guarantees in this world, but if something's been increasing its dividends for the last 50 years plus, it's a pretty good indicator that it could survive downturns. We had 9/11, we had the tech bubble burst, we had this last recession, we've had the pandemic. If it's paying out profits all through all that, pretty confident that it's going to be good going forward. And that's what we end up doing. If you want to learn to build a good recession-proof investment portfolio, check out infinityinvesting.com. You just go right to it and you will see those companies. We isolate them out. Absolutely in the basic area, which is free. You can absolutely take a look at these things and they will help you identify the companies. We still use criteria as to when it's appropriate to buy. We're not big on trying to time the market. What we are big on is saying when something is on sale, let's buy it when it's on sale. A good, valuable company that's going to have good, predictable results and it's on sale, I'm going to buy it. And then you can build your recession-proof investment portfolio as well.